when we are confronted with a challenge. You know, our success really depends on our ability to constantly shift how we see those challenges that are in front of us. If I turn this picture this way, well, there's not much there. But if I turn it around, if I shift our perspective, we get an entirely different picture.
Rockefeller Foundation commissioned acclaimed American artist Phil Hansen to interpret the art of philanthropy.
Not many folks could find art in an economic and political fiasco, but Phil Hansen did. He joins us now by phone.
Whose strong opinions compelled him to put pen to paper.
Phil Hansen almost bailed on a promising career as an artist when he developed a shake in his hand during art school.
And with some encouragement from a friend, I went to a neurologist about the shake. He sat me down, put me through some different tests, and gave me the very simple yet hard diagnosis of permanent nerve damage. And he offers me a little piece of advice. He sort of leans back and he's like, well, if your hand shakes, you know, why don't you just embrace the shake? So that day, when I got home, I put a piece of paper on the wall, I grabbed a pencil, and I just started letting my hand shake and shake, and I started making a bunch of scribble pictures. And that was the first time in my life I ever encountered the idea that embracing a limitation could actually drive creativity. And so when I found that limitations were pushing me creatively, one, I was confused, because that's the opposite of what most of us are taught. You know, we're taught that we need more supplies and more money and more help. And that there I was kind of finding creativity within the confines of my life. And I'm like, that's interesting. Okay, let me kind of dig into that. And so I decided I was going to limit myself and, you know, think about what I could create for a dollar. And I ended up making this image for only 80 cents. And this really became this moment of clarification for me, that we need to first be limited in order to become limitless. So I began to take this approach, as I began to call it and think about it as thinking inside the box. What if I just rethought the paintbrush? What if instead of relying on myself to create all aspects of the art, what if I had to rely on other people to help create the content? You know, what if I just destroyed all the art that I had? So instead of telling each other, as we so often do in this society, to seize the day, I think it's really important that instead we try to remind ourselves every day to seize the limitation. If you're wondering why I have my phone out, the other thing that we're going to do, one of the amazing possibilities is when you have a room full of 6,000 people. To look on the outside for help, as we so often do. We need to bring that reflection back inwards and look at our own internal resources. And I think there's probably one thing initially that almost all of us in this room have in common. And that is that when we run into that obstacle, that thing that's preventing us from moving forward, we so often look on the outside for help. We tend to believe that we need more people to get the job done, you know, maybe more tools, the right tools, or when times are good, we want more money. It's a very natural tendency, because when times are good, you know, we often can rely on things like more people, more money, and more tools. And so we build this habit of counting on external resources. But what happens when those resources become scarce? That is when many of us tend to go into a holding pattern until things flow again. like maybe even way back in the last recession or any sort of local downturn, any sort of point of struggle, so many people, so many individuals, all of us, and even businesses decide to just wait it out. But what's so dangerous about waiting is we end up diverting our attention to the lack of resources. And this creates this habit of noticing things that are out of our control rather than the things we can control. And if you think about it, it's actually the challenging times that give us far more potential for success, to stand out from those around us. And it's in those challenging times that we must recognize that we rely far too much on the external resources, when the most valuable resources we have are within us, you know, our internal resources, our creativity, our adaptability, our resilience.
What is your first response walking out of this keynote?
Amazing. Totally and completely amazing.
If you have a blank open canvas and a million options, it can feel stifling and you don't know how to get started. So just put yourself in a box and then see what you can do there.
And it made me change the way I look at everything that I do professionally, like writing budgets.
Just continue to be creative in your thought process.
In our line of work, we always have to embrace change, difficulties, and Murphy's Law. Sometimes those can be limiting, but if you look at them as being an opportunity, then that's the message.
Embrace your limitations.